But one of the most essential parts of the process is no longer covered by legal aid, and that's the refugee hearing.
Francisco Rico Martinez came to Canada in 1990 as a refugee from El Salvador.
The refugee claimants are going to be in a situation that we haven't seen before.
He and his wife founded the FCJ Refugee Center. They say drastic cuts to legal aid will hurt the most
criminal.
Could you imagine now you will go to a refugee hearing without legal representation? That is going to be also a challenge.
We will be swamped, but we are not going to close the door.
Lidovina, who is now waiting for word on permanent residency, says the journey has been hard, but without legal aid.
With $30, I never can pay a lawyer to do that.
That was Karen Lieberman reporting. In other news, the Toronto District School Board is modernizing its student dress code. For the first time in a decade, the new policy taking effect this fall loosens rules around crop tops, tube tops, and spaghetti straps. Hats, hoodies, and do-rags will also be allowed as long as it does not obscure the face. The TDSB found that some school dress codes unfairly targeted girls, racial groups, cultures, and
conservative super-seek FOMO.
Obama. We'll have that in your national headlines.